What's up, traders? Welcome back to our channel. In this video, I'm gonna show you guys a super simple breakout strategy that you guys can use with EliteAlgo. If you guys like this video, again, make sure you like and subscribe. It helps us, motivates us to keep going and make more videos for you guys. So let's get started. All right, guys, let's get into the strategy. Let me show you guys exactly what you need on your chart so you guys can work on the strategy. So you guys only need really three indicators for the strategy to work. And these indicators are EliteAlgo. Then you need the regular volume indicator that comes default with TradingView. So just go to indicators, type in volume, and then click OK. It's going to show you these green and red bars here at the bottom. And then what you need is the Elite Oscillator here at the bottom as well. And these are the only three indicators that you guys need for this strategy to work. So step number one, guys, is to make sure we guys have the right settings on EliteAlgo to make sure that we are good to go for this breakout strategy. So what we want to do here is we're going to go to EliteAlgo, click on settings, and we want to make sure that our strategy is set to 1.4. We want to turn off these take profit indicators that we see down here, okay? And then we want to make sure that we have the trend cloud turned on. And that's pretty much it for EliteAlgo in terms of settings. Very simple. Press OK. Next, what we want is we're going to go down to the volume indicator. And for this, we have to go into the settings for it, which is up here. We want to make sure that under style, we check on this button right here that says volume MA. Click that. And we'll make this just a very easy color that we can see. So blue works, but let's make the line just a little bit thicker down here so we can better see on our charts, right? And that's pretty much it for that. So press OK. And then the last thing we want to do, guys, you want to go down to where it says Elite Oscillator. Hit settings, go to inputs, and make sure that we change the strategy to Elite TVR. Press OK. Now, for the strategy to work, it's extremely simple. So the way we want to do this is we actually want to look at higher time frames and then trade on smaller time frames. So for example, we're looking for confirmations on the 1 hour, and then we're looking to go down to the 5 minute or the 1 minute and then trade on those time frames in order to get the breakout strategy working. So this is a scalping strategy, and you guys will enjoy this one. Okay, let's get into it. So the first thing we want to look at is once we're on the higher time frames, like the 1 hour that we see right here, is we want to see if we're currently in a buy position or a sell position. Okay, right now we can clearly see we are in a buy position and we have a green trend cloud, which means that we are currently very bullish, right? So that's step number one. Step number two, guys, is you want to wait until you have good volume on the volume oscillator before you enter a trade. So you want to look for a candle that has very strong volume down here. So for example, we can see when the smart buy was given, we have very good volume because the green volume bars are above this blue line, right? This indicates that there is volume right now currently in the market at that time. So let me show you guys exactly what we'd have done to place a trade right here using this strategy, okay? So what we do here, and sorry, one last thing we'll look at is we'll down here at the Elite TVR and just make sure that you have a green line, which indicates that you are not in a range. This is very important as well. So make sure you have a green line on the 1 hour time frame or the 4 hour or the daily, whichever you're using for your multi time frame analysis. I recommend using the 1 hour and the 4 hour. So now that this all checks out, what we're going to do here is we're going to go back in time just to show you guys how this strategy would have worked. So over here, we're just going to set a vertical line so we can fire ourselves back in time where we want to place our trade, right? So we want to trade it always around right here. Okay, now very simple. I'm going to go back in time here, go to the 5 minute chart, and we're just going to look for that line that we placed earlier, which is right here, guys, right? This is where we want to place our trade, okay? Now what we want to do here is we don't want to trade until we get the next buy signal on the smaller time frame. So for example, we're going to wait until it comes back out, and then we get a smart buy signal right here. And this is actually where we want to take our trade, at the smart buy on the lower time frame, guys, right? Then we're going to set our stop loss and take profit behind the swing low, and we're going to use a take profit of 1.5, something like this. And as you can see, this trade would have hit take profit. It's very simple, and this is how easy you guys can use this strategy. So if we go back to the 1 hour time frame, we can look at other candles on the 1 hour time frame that we would have traded on, right? So again, we're looking for candles with high volume. So we see right here that we have very strong volume right here. Okay. So we could have placed another trade on the next smart buy that came after this one here. So for example, we took this trade. This one was a winning trade. We see this, but we could have taken another trade around this area. So let's go ahead and set another line here. Go back down to the 5-minute time frame. And we can see, very easy guys, that we would have waited till the next buy signal after this blue line, right, that we set up, which would have been this one right here. And our trade would have looked like this, guys. Our stop loss behind the last swing low around here. And we can set a 1.5 take profit like that. Very simple. This would have been another good trade that we could have taken on bankniffy right here. And if we keep looking, guys, we can see these setups all over the place. So we keep going, guys. We're looking for more breakouts, right? We're still in the buy position, so we're still looking for scalps that we can take on the 1 hour time, on the 5-minute time frame. So over here, we can see that we have, again, another high volume candle right there, right? Because it is over the blue line. And this is where, again, we can place another trade that would have happened and go back down to the five minute, find the last thing. So we would have placed a trade again on this candle right here for this one with the buy signal, and this would have hit take profit. And we can keep going, guys. 1 hour strategy, go to the next high volume candle, which is this one right here. Go back to the 5-minute and just look for a smart buy that we could take after this, which would have been this smart buy right here, guys. So we've taken a trade right here. Our stop loss, this one, unfortunately, would have been hit. But as you guys can see, it went right back up and hit our 1.5 risk-reward ratio just now. So we got a little bit unlucky with the stop loss here. But as you guys can see, the trade would have went back and hit our take profit because we had very strong momentum on the higher time frames. And just remember, guys, these trades are not going to be 100%, but you are going to get a 60 to 80% win rate using this type of strategy, right? So if we look back again on, let's say, a different pair, or let's go back just in time right here, where we were looking at this buy signal right here. So pretend that this wasn't here yet. We can see very clearly that during this buy signal, we could have taken many trades on the scalp that would have helped us tremendously. So over here, we're looking to see a bullish candle like this one right there. And what we're going to do, actually, before that, we're going to remove all drawings and we're going to go like this. Very simple. Go back in time to find that. Right here, guys. And we just want to wait until the next buy signal, which is over here. We would take the trade on a candle right after, and our stop loss would be set at the last swing low. So something like this. And as you can see, guys, we would have hit take profit here extremely fast on a very fast scalp. That's pretty much how the strategy works. And it's the same thing vice versa for any short signals. If you guys have any questions, go ahead and leave a comment down below and like this video if you guys liked it. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a good day.